All right, here we go. This is gameplay number 8 for Uppercut Games is Submerged. Before we get started really quick, what I'm going to do is kind of wrap up what's been going on since you may or may not have watched all 7 commentaries. Usually when I do them, it's early in the morning. It can be a little bit boring. I totally understand. Totally understand. So, I downloaded this game yesterday. I pre-downloaded it, but yesterday morning about 5 a.m. Yesterday morning being the 7th of August, I finally went ahead and gave this game a go with the recording. Right now, I have 60% of the game complete. It's taken me... I have 60% of the achievements. 10 achievements total, each worth 100 gamer score. I've got a total of 5 hours of game time with 72% of the game actually complete. The achievements that I have earned so far Free Climber, which was the first one, and that was by climbing to the highest point of the map, which is over by the crane. And that was actually yesterday morning, and that was the only achievement I got yesterday morning. Yesterday was the 7th, not the 6th. So this morning I got back up at 5 a.m. I know, believe it or not, waking up on a Saturday at 5 a.m. I mean, dedication, right? You really got to do what you got to do. I have 2 kids and a wife. What I try to do is do all this commentary stuff in the morning. That way they're not running around, being real obnoxious in the background. I just really don't want to take away from the experience. So, you know, today, I had to do a little bit of backtracking today, starting off on, I think it was commentary 3 and 4. Because what I didn't know is when you actually get up to the supplies that you're supposed to find, as soon as you open up those crates, it takes you back to your brother Taku, and you're unable to finish exploring. So the first 2 commentaries I did this morning, so it'd be commentaries number 3 and commentary number 4, were actually spent just going back, tracing my steps back, and getting everything that I had had missed. And then we got back to the actual storyline. So this morning early, I was able to unlock the achievements Wish You Were Here, which was the achievement for using the postcard feature. You really didn't even have to use the postcard feature. All you had to do was just open it up, mess around with it a little bit, hit the back button, and voila, you got the achievement. The next achievement I got was circumnavigation, and that was for reaching both the north, east, south, and west boundaries of the map. Too easy to do. You just go in that cardinal direction, and when you hit that boundary, it'll go ahead and automatically turn your boat away from the boundary so you know that you actually hit that location. The next achievement was naturalist. That just kind of happened on its own just from riding around in my boat here. I ended up seeing all of the sea creatures and popped that one for 100 gamer score as well. There's 2 that I did. The next one was Mariner. Mariner is achieved by staying in the boat for an entire day and night cycle. Now, I will tell you the best time to get this one is when you're trying to float around looking for boat pieces to upgrade your boat. The reason why is it took me, I think, about 30 to 35 minutes to complete a cycle, day-night cycle. So it took a minute. So good thing I had other objectives. And then finally, Sightseer. Sightseer kind of came on its own a little bit. I did attempt to kind of find all the landmarks, but you pop that achievement once you visit all the landmarks. And you'll know you hit a landmark because when you've right up to it, you kind of zoom out a little bit, and basically names it. So what I'm doing right now, I'm about to go to my objectives, but I don't want to end the game too early because of the fact that I had the issue yesterday with opening the crates and being teleported back away from my location. It kind of forced me to waste a lot of time heading on back. So what I'm doing now is floating around, trying to look for some secrets. Like, here's one right here. I would never have found that if I wasn't floating around, because that's not actually one of my objectives. I'm just happened to be somewhere that I was boating around. I need to find some more boat pieces so I can fully upgrade my boat. When I do that, I'll pop another achievement for 100 gamer score. These books that I'm collecting are supposedly the secrets of what's going on. I have a feeling that I'm literally going to have to visit every single building in this map, which might take a long time. There's 60 books. Each location where you go and find some supplies usually has anywhere from 2 to, I think I've seen 5 books at one. But there's 60 of them total, so I mean, you really got some exploring to do. And I don't know if it's... there you go. So here you go. Here's the ones that I'm missing. Now, so there's all the landmarks, 8 landmarks, 8 creatures. We have the city story, which is kind of explaining what's going on. Now, when you find a building that has supplies on it, which I'm about to go to my next one, I'm going to go ahead and jump forward with that. I may or may not sit here and waste my time with you guys just looking for these boat pieces. What I might do, I'm going to try this one. These little X's that you find on the map, I think that's where a boat was found. I don't think that that's the actual location, because I go back to them and I mean there's no boat here anymore, so I think that's where I actually found a boat. Let's just circle it to make sure. Anyway, what I'm probably going to find myself do is actually going through this this map just on my own, trying to find the boat pieces, because it'd be a very, very, very boring commentary if I sat here and talked the entire time. If you listen to my other ones, you can see this one's probably a little bit more energetic than others. Big reason for that is I don't have to be as quiet, and I've been awake for a while, so it's I could be more excited. Thinking about to find myself a book. Let's see. Yeah, there we go. Just like that, there's another book. So I got 12 more of these to go. I think I will head to my objective, but I will just kind of look around while I'm there. There's probably going to be a jump in what's going on. Oh, come on now, get out of there. Do I got to go rivers? Excuse me, I'm sorry, I did not. Didn't do that. I've been sick, so I am actually stuck here. There we go. Okay, so long story short, I never get sick. I eat relatively healthy. I exercise. I never get sick. So, of course, right before I'm about to do my very first commentary, I get sick. Wouldn't you know it? It's getting better today. I've had 2 cups of coffee, been up since 5 a.m., kind of stayed in the house, didn't do a whole lot, and, oh, see, there we go, there's a boat. All right, we're getting there. How many more pieces we got? See, and this is what I'm doing. There's only 5 more boat pieces. I'm literally just driving around, visiting each and every single one of the buildings that I can find, hoping to find either a boat piece or a book to kind of facilitate those 2 achievements, and I'll take some notes when the achievements do pop. I will take some notes that way I can see it. What is this? Is there anything on? So I haven't been here. I keep hitting back buttons at X. No way, I have been there. Maybe I haven't. See, I don't know what's going on. This game seems to be doing a lot of skipping right now. Let's see what happens when I... Have I been here before? Let's see. I don't remember if I've been here before. I have been. Yep, I've been here before. Alright, I won't waste my time there. Just trying to find these secrets. I have not been... this way. This is new. Anyway, so back to my story. I never get sick. Yeah, I'm sure a lot of you have probably been in the same... I'm sorry, I'm just looking at my map a lot because I'm trying to go where I haven't gone, but... Anyway, never get sick. right before I do my first commentary, I, of course, get sick. So that's usually how things go. I'm going to talk about the game here in a minute. Just get some of my water. So, Epoch. Epoch is obviously one of Uppercut's games. Relatively well known on the iPad. I think I purchased it before I went to the Philippines in January of 2014. I was deployed to the southern Philippines doing some work there. I did play it while I was gone. It was an okay game. I mean, it wasn't blockbuster in my opinion, but it was okay. Now, we all know Uppercut Games is a small company. I think they, from my understanding, this is their first real attempt at a, there's got to be something up, there we go, yeah, I got a book. And this is their first decent attempt at a console game. So, for some reason, just something really stuck out about this game for me. As soon as I saw the preview for it, I was like, oh man, maybe some music, you know, I'm a diehard fan of good music. Halo, for example. Halo, if Halo didn't have the music that it has, it probably wouldn't be as good of a game, in my opinion. I'm a sucker for good soundtrack. You get a good soundtrack, and you'll suck me right into that. Just like, for example, Battlestar Galactica. Okay, let's talk Battlestar Galactica. Now, I'm not talking the 1970s one. I think it was the 70s. I'm talking the 2010 Edward James Olmos Battlestar Galactica, the reimagining. I'm kind of a Star Trek fan now because of the new movies, but it's never really a huge, like, I love space, don't get me wrong, I love space, I love Star Wars, stuff like that. For some reason, like, Star Trek never really, never really got to me in a way. And, you know, I think some of that might have had to do with, you know, maybe my age, but regardless, when I first saw the previews for Battlestar Galactica, my buddy was telling me about it, I was just kind of like, it looks too Star Trek-y, but, not only was, we got here, another boat, not only was the, sweet, we're getting there, the way, I keep hitting the damn wrong button. Anyway, not only was the way that the filming was done for Battlestar Galactica amazing, but the soundtrack was amazing. I'm talking like, wow, you know what I mean? It just sucks you right in. It's emotional. It keeps the pace when it needs to. Is there something wrong here? It's probably the best. Oh, look, man, another boat. Look at that. Anyway, it is probably the most amazing. I think so. Amazing soundtrack to any TV show, really ever. I mean, let's talk concept here. Battlestar Galactica. You have 13 original colonies. So, going back from my understanding of kind of how things work, or how things worked in the movie. And I believe I learned somewhere that there's 13 solar cycles in a calendar year, but we only have 12 months. I remember being told that way back in the day, you know, they went by 13 months. So Battlestar Galactica, if anybody doesn't know, 13 colonies. 13 colonies, 13 gods. They get together, they band, and, for the survival of the human race, they migrate in search of a new planet called Earth. Meanwhile, back in the Battlestar Galactica universe, it's kind of like almost like a Terminator thing, where they build robots, the robots turn on them, They go to this long war that lasts forever, and then they finally have a peace agreement, and then the Cylons disappear in their own part of the world, or the galaxy, I'm sorry. They eventually come back and just rage havoc on the 12 remaining, or 13 remaining, there's 12 colonies, the 13th one left. So they rage war. Just got people over here. They rage war on the 12 colonies that are still around. Meanwhile, the 13th one is kind of out and about. Annihilate the human race. Nuke all their civilizations. I mean, there is nothing they can do to survive this. They come in where they can't see them, and they just dominate in the war. So the only people who really survived were the ones who were kind of out in space, flying around. They managed to... here's another book. They managed to survive because they weren't on any of the 13 colonies. They were like in transit. So imagine you're in your car driving to work, and both your home and your work get blown up. I mean, you only survived because you were not at either one of those locations. So all that's left of the human population is 50,000 people, and they have to go on and... how do I get there? my throat's really dry. I'm sorry, because I've been sick, and here I am talking anyway. So, 50,000 people left. They have to go on the run away from the Cylons. The Cylons are chasing them, trying to kill them, and then, they're running for their lives, and they go to war with the Cylon, and they have to find shelter and food and ammo and all this other stuff while they're running. Not only are they running, but they're also looking for the 13th colony. They're looking for Earth. And then eventually, spoiler alert, eventually they find Earth, but it's not Earth as you imagine today, and it's not Earth in the future. It's Earth 50,000 years ago when man was just kind of starting out here. So the theory that kind of presses forward with the Battlestar Galactica franchise is that, the 12 colonies, or the 13th colony made it to Earth, the 13th colony started populating Earth and back to the primitive days, or primitive ages of man. And eventually the survivors of the 12 colonies found them, joined them, but they didn't join with their technology. They reset. They said, it's time to give up our spaceships and our technology. We want to blend in here. We want to forget about our past, and we want to make things work. So that's the synopsis of Battlestar Galactica. Way, 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 way more to say about it. But we got to be talking about like specific episodes, because I mean, this thing is just... It's just amazing. Just amazing. Okay. I think I'm... damn it, I did it again. Yep. Here we go. Coming to my objective now. So my whole point was to get to this objective. I was just kind of taking my time getting there, so that I can find some stuff along the way. But this is definitely what I'm looking for. If I can figure out how to get in here. There we go. Let's go Tomb Raider. So this is what I'm talking about. Once you actually get to your objective, it shows you 1, 2, 3, there's 4 books here. So I'm going to climb around this one for a minute. If you listen to the previous couple of these commentaries, I just want to apologize right now. The settings on my phone got messed up, and for some reason it recorded everything at really low quality. So I had to take them into a converter in the WAV format and try to make them a little bit better than they were. Did okay, I think, but it's You know, I'm learning. I'm brand new to this, right? Brand new. See, what is this thing? It's so creepy. God, I keep seeing it. Just jumped right out into... Alright, well, I guess I'm gonna go around here first. And I'm pretty sure he is turning into one of those things. Pretty sure. So there's normally, yeah, I mean, there's all kinds of indicators to tell you where stuff is. The books flash, there's always these little bugs. You know, there's these bugs kind of flying around. It's easy to find what you need to find when you really try. I mean, when you really look. I'm not saying I'll find all 60 of these books on the first time go. It's probably going to be another one of those things where I'm
just doing it on my own without commentating because I want to get the achievements. I mean, honestly, 10 achievements, 100 gamer score each.
Good opportunity to boost your gamer score right here by 1,000 points. Of course, I should just wait until the day of release to buy this thing because, you know, here's a problem I'm running into. You know, I'm brand new, so just getting into this business, it's a lot of work. It's a slow payoff. I've got 5 subscribers, I think, as of tonight, August 8th, 2015. You know, within 3 days, I haven't had very many views on my gameplay, but of course, you know, the big guys, the big players, they've got 30,000 views, you know, and it's like, damn it, man, that's exactly what I was trying to do, but, yeah, you know, I'm the underdog, whatever. I'm like a small business. That's how it is. You're trying to do things. Trying to do things your own way, and it's going to take some time to get an audience. That's where I need you guys. That's where I need to, you know, make sure I'm doing stuff like getting the beta plays and the live streams and all that good stuff. Man, this chick climb. See, I'm going to have to get over there too. I know there's a damn book. Over there to the bottom right. So I'm going to have to go up and back down. And this is why you wait till the very end to get to your crate. Because you do not want to have to come do all this stuff again. Because this crate's going to be at the very top. And right over there on the other side of this building is where I climb back down. And it looks like the crates are on that side. You know, so speaking of the video, there's a lot of things I can do differently, to kind of speed up the quality. I mean, I'm sorry, not speed up the quality, but, you know, really to kind of, what the hell's going on? See, I'm really starting to jump a lot right here. I can do stuff like just commentate, but not everybody enjoys commentaries. So, like I mentioned in a previous commentary, actually. How in the hell do I get... Just look at this. Pretty sure I gotta get down there. Anyway, it's a lot of work, so I record this and then I record the video and the commentary on two different devices. Then I create basically two, one with commentary, one without. It takes a lot of time to encode, do all that good stuff. Let's see, here's a damn book right here. And I just can't produce stuff fast enough. And then, you know, it ends up being, hey, we're going to get, you know, one of the more popular channels are going to throw the video up at the same time and basically just undo everything I was trying to do. So, is what it is. Now, if I go, see, there's that book. There's that damn book that I got to get. So, hopefully I can climb down here. See, look at that. Wow, how do I get that book? I see. You just gotta run around and then back up. Got it, okay. So let me go get this last book. That is the last one for this building. I'm gonna get that book. And then I will grab the crate. I will find myself back with Taco, or Taku. People call him Taco. I think his name is Taku. And then let this video encode, come back, do our next commentary. Same thing, maybe fly around a little bit, try to find some stuff. I think what I'll do is go find some more boats and stuff like that. And then just, I guess just see what I gotta do is run around this side over here. Come on, get on. So it's in the opposite side of this building, so I run to the other corner and climb up like I did right there.
Makes sense.
Like, I don't know if you guys can hear my wife's cats in the background, but at night they just get really annoying. All they do is just meow all day. See, I thought it was right there. Uh-oh. Oh, my brother's actually texting me right now asking how submerged it is and whether or not it's worth the... Damn it, I know. I saw that thing here. What's going on? I know I saw that book. See you, babe. Yeah, so my brother just texted me and asked me how submerged. Is it worth $15? Is this game worth buying? I believe so. I believe it's worth buying. I think it's a good, I mean, if you like Tomb Raiders and you like games that it's not impossible to get the achievements, stuff like that, then I think this is, you know, a decent game for the money. Decent game for the money. Actually, I haven't told my brother about my YouTube channel. Pretty new at this. I think the Facebook page right now is sitting somewhere around 1,400 likes, which is pretty good, I think. There we go. Let's get it. All right, I'm going to go ahead and grab this in the commentary here so I don't have to cut it too short. And then I will see you guys on the flip side. Number 9.